Hello friends, this is DK Gautam and thank you for joining Interview Point.
So friends, in this video I am going to discuss about dependency injection in C sharp. So guys, if you are going for interview and this question you have to prepare very well. So this is the very important question for freshers and as well as for the experienced candidate. So what is dependency injection in C sharp? So it is a design pattern, or we can say dependency injection is a software design pattern, and it is a technique for achieving inversion of control between classes and their dependencies. So it allows us to develop loosely coupled code, or we can say it allows developers to develop loosely coupled code. I will explain this so that you can understand better. And it makes code maintainable. And next point is, it also helps to reduce the tight coupling between software components. And the last point is, dependency injection enables us to better manage future changes and other complexity in our software development. Okay, so guys, there are three types of classes. So like we can say, dependency injection patterns involves three types of classes. Okay, so first one is client class. So client class is responsible for the client class. Dependent class is a class which depends on the service class. So this client class is dependent on the service class. So service class dependency is a class that provides service to the client class. So this class providing service to this client class. Okay, the third or last class is injector class. The injector class injects the service class object into the client class. So guys, let me show you how we can work with the dependency injection in ASP.NET Core. So guys, if you already have watched my video this one, ASP.NET REST APIs in .NET Core 3.1, so I am using this project only to understand the better how the dependency injection work in .NET Core. So guys, I hope you already know that ASP.NET Core supports built-in support for the dependency injection. So mostly, or I can say 95% of, or we can say 99% of the developer are using dependency injection if they are using .NET Core. Okay, so if they are using the .NET Core 2.0 or 3.1, so the latest one is 3.1. okay guys, so like we are having a startup class here. The configure service method is very important, and suppose this is the employee class. So this is very simple class. We are having four properties: id, name, department and salary. And this is a service class. So this is the db context, and this is a variable we have created. So by using this variable, we are accessing the data from the database. Okay guys, so this is the service, or we can say client class. So we will call this class. Okay, we will call this, and this interface we have to implement. So this interface is implemented by this employee service class. So this class is responsible to implement this interface. So that's why this is the interface, and in this employee service we are inheriting the I employee service. Okay, so that's why this employee service class is responsible to implement the I employee service. So we are having here five methods: get employee, get employee by id. So all the methods are implemented here: get employee, get add employee, update employee and delete employees. All the methods are here, and this class is this employee service class is implementing that. Okay, so here this is the main point here. So this is the controller we are using here, the dependency injection. Whenever our application loads, so the application goes here in the startup class. Here in the startup class, it will find one method, configure service. So this method is responsible to add the service to the container. We are having this add transient. We are having other method as well, add singleton as well. So we are mostly we will work with three methods here, but we are having add transient and add singleton. Okay, so this is the I employee service, and this is the service class, and this is the interface. Okay, so we are using this container. Okay, so this method, configure service method, is used to provide the service to the container. So we are adding the service to the container. Okay, so this service will be ready to use. So whenever our application will be loaded, this service is ready to use. And when someone will call this controller. So what happens here? We are having one private variable of type IEmployeeService. So this is the constructor injector. So by using this constructor, what we are doing here? We are by using this variable IEmployeeService, we are accessing our methods. Okay. So that's why. But we are not using here new keyword, but we can do by using the new keyword as well. So here we are using the constructor. So this service will be ready. Actually, this service is already ready, but we are using this constructor injector. Okay, guys. So this is ready, but this is here loosely coupled. We can, if we will write here new keyword, we can do by using the new keyword as well, but that will be the tight coupled. Okay, so here this is the loosely coupled. So whenever suppose in the future, right now we are having only one employee controller, so in the real time we are having multiple controls, like thousands of controller. Okay, so that will be the
very tedious job
to create the instance of the service by using the new keyword. So like suppose right now I am using this IEmployeeService. Okay, so I am using this IEmployeeService class. Okay, so right now it is very easy. Okay, but in case of in the future, if I will use another class, so that will be very difficult. So to solve this problem, we are using this startup class, and we have to just change here. Okay, so right now I am using IEmployeeService class, so I am injecting this class. Okay, so like in future I don't want to use this IEmployeeService class and I want to use another class, so I have to change here only, and this service will be ready. So that is all about the dependency injection. I hope guys you enjoyed this video. If you have any doubt, you can ask me through comment. We'll see you in the next video.
Thanks for watching this video. Guys, please subscribe our YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed, you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn. This is my blog URL. You can check it out. Guys, if you have any doubt, you can ask me through comment. Please provide your feedback. Thanks.